Okay, so far I have been speaking a lot regarding carbon compounds. Now let's try to get in-depth knowledge of carbon chemistry. What exactly is carbon? What exactly is the bond pattern in carbon? And how carbon is able to form these compounds? Okay, let's start with the symbol first. So the symbol for carbon is C. And you could see this in the periodic table as well. So the atomic number of carbon is 6. So as you know that atomic number of carbon is 6, so you can generally write the electronic configuration as 2-4, where 2 is the number of electrons in the K shell and 4 is the number of electrons in the L shell. Right, so you might have already been having an idea about writing electronic configuration. So I would write the electronic configuration of carbon is 1s2, 2s2 and 2px1, 2py1 and 2pz0. Okay, so this is the best way to write down the electronic configuration. So now let's have a look at the valence shell. Valence shell is the outermost shell. So if you could see, the second shell is the outermost shell and it contains two subshells, that is 2s and 2p. Right, 2p has three, like 2px, 2py and 2pz. So these two, this subshell contains 4 electrons. So you could simply say the number of valence electrons are equal to 4. Now, what do you mean by valency? Valency is number of electrons required to complete octet. Right? Every single element would like to become a noble gas by either gaining, losing electron or more than one electron. So I would say electron or electrons, right? So carbon has 4 electrons in this outermost shell. So it needs 4 electrons to complete octet. So that means you could say the valency of carbon is equal to 4. So what exactly does this mean? So let's have a look again. So carbon is 2, 4. So let's say if it loses 4 electron. So I'm writing minus 4 electron. Then it becomes 2, which is nothing but a duplet. Again, it becomes stable. Now let's say if it gains 4 electron. Now what exactly happens? When it gains 4 electron, it gets a configuration 2, 8. That means outermost shell has completed the octet. So it is simply, you could say that octet rule is followed in this case. So carbon can gain 4 electron as well as lose 4 electron. So carbon prefers to share. So carbon normally forms covalent bond. Covalent bond by sharing of electrons. Now let's have a look at the bond pattern, which I have been consistently telling this. So now let's have a look at how could you form different types of compound. Now carbon, when I'm writing an element, it is necessary that I should put all the 4 electrons. So I'll just write one electron, one electron, one electron, one electron. This is one pattern. I can have carbon wherein I'm going to put 2 electrons together. I'm going to put 1 electron here, 1 electron here, right? And I could have something like this, carbon, wherein I'm going to put 3 electrons together and 1 electron here. Now, let's try to see what exactly is going to happen now. Now, I'm going to try to explain you what exactly is a bond pattern. It could form a single bond and a multiple bond. What exactly is going to happen now? Now, let's say you have hydrogen and you know atomic number of hydrogen is 1, so it has 1 electron. So, for my convenience, I'm going to represent the atom of hydrogen, in terms of their electron, and the electron is going to be represented as a dot. So, this dot represents electron of hydrogen. So, I have one more hydrogen with a dot, again a hydrogen with a dot, again one more hydrogen with a dot. Now, carbon can form bond by sharing of electrons. So, these two electrons form a bond, these two electrons form a bond, these two electrons form a bond, again these two electrons form a bond. Now, if you have a look at this, this is nothing but a molecule methane. So, you could say that carbon can form single bond. Now, let's have a look at the second one. In this case, I have written the number of electrons, valence electrons, in a different pattern. So, there are single electrons and then these two electrons I have written together. Now, let's see if I have one more carbon and I have the same electron pattern over here. So, now let's try to see what exactly would happen. Let's say if I have a hydrogen with one electron here, if I have a hydrogen with one electron here, if I have a hydrogen with one electron here, if I have a hydrogen with one electron here. So now two electrons form a bond, two electrons form a bond, two electrons form a bond. Again the same thing happens here. Now what exactly is going to happen here? These two carbons are going to share their electrons as well. So it forms a single bond. Again one more electron is there, so you have these two electrons form a bond. So now have a look at this. So this is nothing but a double bonded compound, right? So you can say carbon forms double bond. Okay, now let's have a look at this. So you have, I have written three electrons together. So now let me put one more carbon here with the same pattern. So 1, 2, 3 electron, then you have one electron over here. So you have hydrogen coming with one electron, you have hydrogen coming with one electron, right? So let me try to join the, draw the bonds. So you have two electrons forming a bond, two electrons forming a bond, again two electrons are forming a bond. Again the same thing is happening here, same thing is happening here, right? So if you could see, carbon even forms a triple bond. So that means carbon can form single bond as well as double bond as well as triple bond. So, in every case, carbon is forming four bonds. Now, let's try to check whether carbon is completing octet in each case. So, this carbon is surrounded by four electron of its own. So, I'll write four electron plus this is a covalent bond. So, I can count the electrons from hydrogen as well. So, you have four, fifth electron, sixth electron, seventh and eighth. So, now this carbon has 4 plus 4, which is equal to 8 electrons. Now let's have a look at this. This carbon is surrounded by 1, 2, 3, 4, which are the electrons of its own. Then you have 5, 6, then you have 7 and 8. So you have this carbon completing an octet, and again this carbon is also completing an octet if you could count. Now let's have a look at this. You have 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons, 4 electron, 5th electron from hydrogen, and 6, 7, 8. The remaining three electrons, that is 6th, 7th and 8th electron from the other carbon. So this carbon has also completed the octet. Now if you could carefully observe, each hydrogen in this case is surrounded by two electrons, so it already completes a duplet. So that means the structures which we have written is the representation of carbon forming four bond. So that is the reason carbon is called as tetravalent. That means it can form four bonds. Now, one thing that could be coming to your mind, that why is it that I didn't write something like this? Carbon forming four bonds with itself. Now, let's have a look at it. So, let's say if carbon forms four bonds with itself, so this could be the pattern. So, two electrons form a bond, again one bond, again one bond, again one bond. Now, just imagine, is there anything, is there something different in this case? These compounds contain carbon and hydrogen, carbon and hydrogen. Again, here it is carbon and hydrogen. But if you will have a look at this, this contains only carbon. So that is the reason. If carbon forms four bonds with itself, then there is no space or no bond for hydrogen. This is the reason carbon cannot form four bonds with itself. There could be cases like diamond and graphite wherein each carbon is bonded to four other carbons, right? So that is a different case. So this was about the tetravalency of carbon. So let's have a quick review of what we have studied just now. We started with the symbol, which is C, and the atomic number, which is 2, 4, four electrons in the valence shell. So you have K shell and L shell. In this case, L shell is the valence shell. So I wrote the different bond patterns, and I've just explained carbon needs four electron. It can take four electron, it can give four electron. So it prefers sharing of electron, that is formation of a covalent bond. Then we were able to write down the structure of different carbon compounds. First were single bonded compounds, then we had a double bonded, then you have a triple bond. So this was about the tetravalency of carbon. Now in the next session, we'll be studying about other properties of carbon and other properties of carbon compounds as well.